Okay, so when this video goes live, which will be on October 24th, 11:39 and 46 seconds Eastern, something amazing will be happening. My team's observations using the James Webb Space Telescope will commence of the target Kepler-167. So I just thought I should do a quick unscripted video just telling you how I feel, how crazy this is, and how excited I am for the observations that are about to happen. So some background, I mean, some of you already know this, but if you've been a long-time subscriber, you know this, but we have been hoping to find exomoons for a very long time. In fact, for me, it's been literally, you know, most of my professional career, I've been trying to do this alongside other things as well, but that has been a continuous thread in my career. Moons around exoplanets. We have this planet, Kepler-167e. It is a planet which I actually found, 2016, I think it was. It's like 10 years ago now, almost. Is a planet that I found that is as close to Jupiter as you could possibly hope for, and that it's transiting its star. So it's within 1% the mass of Jupiter, 10% the radius of Jupiter. It goes around its star on a nice wide circular orbit. Its temperature is kind of comparable to Jupiter as well. It's about 150 Kelvin. So everything about this star just really lines up. But the problem is this planet only eclipses its star, you know, passes in front of the star once every roughly 3 years. So if we didn't observe it at WST, this transit, which was coming up and is literally happening right now as you're watching this video, you think about that, look up, that planet is transiting that star right now. If we didn't get it then, we would have to wait 3 years, right? And who knows, maybe WST might not even be operating in 3 years. Big meteor could strike it or something. I mean, I really hope not, but that could always happen. So we knew this was a golden opportunity. Like, we had to get it. We put in our proposal, and amazingly, they gave us the time. It's actually kind of incredible because they've given us 60 hours. So for 2.5 days, the next 2.5 days from the moment you watch this video, if you watch it when it first comes out, until 2.5 days later, we will be pointing JWST at this one star, monitoring this thing to watch the transit of the planet in front of that star, and hopefully detect moons on top of that planet as well. So very exciting. So I just want to sort of set some expectations today. What are we going to tell you? Because this, we have a year preparatory period on this data. So we have a year before the data goes public. And that's fairly normal with JWST observations, you know, a year for the team to really figure out what's going on. It's really tempting, trust me. I've been in this situation many times. You get the data on the first day, you see a dip, and you're like, that's it, we're there, we've got a moon or whatever it is. And then you realize, you know, a few weeks, a few months later, it's not real. So we don't want to get people's excitement up prematurely. And it's my job to have those rises and falls of emotion. And I don't want you to necessarily have all those same feelings and confusion about what's going on. So our plan is not to do updates every like week or few months or whatever on this channel. We want to tell you when we're done. Like whenever we feel like we figure out what the answer is and we're confident about it, then I'll come on here and tell you what is going on. And trust me, as soon as that answer is ready to be told, Cool Worlds will be the first place to hear that news. I promise you that. So that's going to be exciting. I can't wait to just see what that light curve looks like. But I am prepared for the emotional roller coaster of these ups and downs that you so often get with these types of observations. So just one thing, expectations, don't expect us to be like telling you every little change we have in our analysis. Oh, look what we found, look what we found, look what we found. We're gonna wait till we're confident we know what we found. I think that's just honestly just being a good scientist. It is an exciting set. Not only do we get these moons potentially, we also think we can measure the ablateness and the obliquity of this exoplanet for the first time. So a ton of really exciting science that you just have to tune in and hear about. One extra thing I want to tell you about just before I leave, this is supposed to be a quick unscripted video, so I apologize, it's a little bit disoriented compared to my usual content. But one quick thing I want to tell you is one way to get earlier access, and maybe I'll give you some hints as to what we are seeing and give you some updates about the stage of the analysis where we're at. I don't want to get people's hopes up about possible signals, but I was certainly, I'm happy to update everybody about, okay, we've got a white light curve. Okay, we've processed this stage. Okay, we're now looking at the atmosphere. We're now looking at the ablateness signal. All those stages and how we're doing, I'm thinking of doing that on the live stream. So we have a live stream. It is only for donors. So this is kind of the plug, I guess. It's only for donors. So if you become a supporter to the Cool Worlds channel, which you can do so using the link down below in the description, it's coolworldslab.com/support. Head there and you become a supporter. You get access to our live streams. And on there, I will give a little bit more juice about what is going on. So that's one way to help. And it also really helps out because our budget, we requested a budget for JWST to do this analysis. It was slashed in half by NASA. NASA's struggling with money right now. We've talked about that on this channel before. So, you know, it's tricky to get the funding to actually do this kind of work. So your support really helps us. And listen, I am convinced this will be a historic set of measurements that we're about to take. Because the thing is, whether we see a moon or not, it's going to be a really profound result. Of course, if we see a moon, it's the first kind of slam dunk JWST XO moon that we all can hopefully stand behind and say, look, we've got a moon just like the moon in the solar system, like Ganymede, like Callisto. And everybody will hopefully converge and be like, yay, this is a real XO moon. That's kind of the dream scenario. But there's also the scenario that we don't see anything. And we know we should, with JWST, see moons that small. And yet this is a planet which is as close to Jupiter as you could really possibly hope for. We would have to essentially rip up the textbook on moon formation, because, you know, Saturn, even Saturn, which is, you know, much lighter than Jupiter, has Titan, which we should also detect. And yet if we don't see a Titan, we don't see a Ganymede, we don't see a Callisto, that is telling us, I think, something quite profound about moon formation. Maybe the solar system is kind of special. So that's going to be an extraordinary result either way. So I'm very excited about this. I feel like I have waited 15 years for this day, for this moment, which is happening right now as you look up. Maybe you're just looking at a ceiling like I am, but you can think about that, looking up at that planet. It's in the Cygnus constellation, so you can go out if you're in the Northern Hemisphere and go and catch that. But it's an amazing opportunity that we have to potentially test some long-standing theories, and also just a dream that I've had for my entire career. So I hope you're excited about this. As I said, stay tuned to Cool Worlds for updates. Feel free to, if you can and you're interested in, you can become a supporter and think we're worthwhile to the Cool Worlds Lab, and then you can get a little previews of what's happening on the live stream. And listen, just be excited. There is big things happening in the world of exoplanets, and this is the place to hear all about that. So until next time, guys, stay thoughtful and stay curious.